As Josephine Goldmark recalled the scene in her biography of Florence Kelly, Mr. Choate first emphasized how busy he was and much pressed for time. "What did this Oregon law do, after all?" the lawyer said in his booming voice. "A law prohibiting more than 10 hours a day in laundry work. Big, strong laundry women," he continued. "Why shouldn't they work longer?" Florence Kelly saw her opportunity and jumped in immediately. "Why not indeed," she replied, in her most charming and agreeable manner. She apologized for taking the time and attention of such a busy, important man for such a small matter. The two women promptly exited before the discussion would be extended and the lawyer be given a chance to reconsider. June 18, 2011. The New York Public Library Archives, a church where the past is worship. Outside, New York has more tourists and more languages are heard than ever. Chinese, Korean, French, Russian, German, Spanish, Arabic. A group of women in full-length black Muslim dress and headscarves walking briskly into Saks Fifth Avenue across the street. Before his appointment to the Supreme Court of the United States, Louis Brandeis was already well known as a champion of workers. In 1908, he urged a comprehensive system of social insurance against the hazard of industrial accidents, illness, old age, and unemployment. He was also Josephine Goldmark's brother-in-law. Florence Kelly knew she wanted Louis Brandeis to argue the case for the Oregon Consumers League and for the National Consumers League as soon as she heard the Supreme Court of the United States had agreed to hear the case.